Hello and welcome again to Channel 48. My name is Puck. How are you doing on this Wednesday? Little bit windy and rainy outside, but hey, with a nice cup of coffee and a beautiful Samsung S2 in my hands, I feel just fine. So what is it today about? Well, in my previous video I showed you the Samsung Galaxy S3, and of course now we arrived at the S2. So Android Oreo, or even Pi, for the Samsung Galaxy S2. Yes, you can. It's available, and that with thanks to king of this phone, Mr. Rinaldo from XDA. So Rinaldo started a while ago when I got his first Android 8 ROM. I remember I called it the psychedelic ROM, and it had all sorts of strange colors, but it worked, and it was the beginning of something very fantastic that would happen to this phone. After many development builds, we at a certain moment reached a good working Android 8.1 for this phone, as well by the same developer, Mr. Rinaldo. In fact, I should call him King Rinaldo, because he's the king of this phone. So, not very long after that, he started with developing Android 9 for this phone. Android 9. I have the latest version here. I'm gonna show you how to install it. And I'm also going to tell you the things that you need to know. Companies that deserve credit for this happening to the Samsung Galaxy S2 is Team Win Recovery Project, TWRP, Lineage OS, you know. Of course, all the other developers that did so many things as well, that also, you know, this is not one person, these are many people that are working all together. This is a group, so this is Rinaldo and his group, but Rinaldo is the head developer and the maintainer of the Samsung Galaxy S2. So all credits for whatever you're gonna see in this video goes to Mr. and King Rinaldo, king of the Galaxy Samsung S2. Let me put you on the tripod and let me show you what it became. Okay guys, there we are. Welcome back. As you can see, my Ubuntu phone arrived. Here it is. A review about that is still coming up. I have a little unpack review. So there we go. This is the ROM, Android 9, for this beautiful phone, the Samsung Galaxy S2. And what we now gonna do, we're just gonna reboot, and we're gonna go into a recovery mode, and I'm gonna show you what you can get on your phone if you already partitioned your internal flash drive. Okay, that's very important, otherwise it will not work. Okay, you need a system partition of at least 1.5 gigabytes. Alrighty, so let's just wipe the complete phone. Advanced Delphi Catch System Data. Okay, boom, there we go. And we're flashing. You can see that the temperature is also very low of the phone, 41 degrees Celsius. That is beautiful temperature. So the ROM that I was talking about is not on here, it's on the internal drive, on the eMMC. Here it is, you see that? Lineage OS 16, created on the 24th of February, so that was last week. So this is a very young and new build by, of course, Rinaldo, my brother from another mother. And of course the king of this phone. And there we go. This is beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Even the numbers of the, look at that. the numbers. Look at the numbers of the temperature. 73%. 3 and 7 makes 10. That is 1. Look at the temperature. Look at the time. 8.3 makes 11. You know? And there, CPU 4.8, that makes 12. 10, 11, 12. You see that? So sometimes in numbers you can see what things are, how good, and yeah, I cannot explain. If you cannot read numbers, then it's gonna be hard for you to explain the meaning of numbers. But number one is a very, very good, very good, good number. Most people with big careers, if you take the date of their birthday, if they were born on the 19th, people that are born on the 19th, most of the times are people that will come very far in life. They will be toppers, winners, you know? Okay, so there we go. The two red lines, don't worry about it. That is has to, something to do with my my other partition. That is, don't worry about it. So now we're gonna boot up the phone and you're gonna take a look at a real-time boot. That while I'm gonna take a look at my Ubuntu phone. Lovely. Can you see what is happening there? It's booting. This is the home screen. Needs internet. So I don't even know where my applications are. I don't know nothing about this phone. Oh, geïnstalleerd. Oh, okay. Oh, and up here you can give ratings or what? Oh, like that you can bring the applications into. News, my photos, calls, SoundCloud, oh that's cool, Ubuntu store. So that means I just added them to did they come here? Not really. I think there's nothing installed on this thing, or maybe I must connect to the internet first and then suddenly all sorts of things gonna happen. I thought I had to slide. I saw the guy in the video sliding this way like that, but here nothing happens. Here. At least I can make phone calls. There's no back button. Back button is like this. Try vertrekken om te verversen. I must connect to the internet. Let me do that. Okay, we just arrived here. Hey, look at that. We arrived. Oh, hello, hello. Look at that. Look at that beautiful thing there, man. Ach, ach, ach. No. How do we do that? How do we quit here? Like that. Next. 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 You see, it says Dutch SIM detected. But the SIM card is already expired. Labara always expires if you don't buy credit and you don't use the SIM too much. Suddenly the SIM is not working anymore. It's not connecting. But this is it, guys. Android Pie for your Samsung Galaxy S2. Here you can see it's running and up. And it looks amazingly nice. See that? 9100. Here, Android version is 9. Beautiful Mac number, bolt number, everything is there. If you want to root it, I think you can root it with add-on to ARM 16 from Lineage OS. Maybe SuperSU will help you, or maybe even, yeah, in fact, I don't know. I did not root this device yet. Only thing I know is that it works good, okay? And the camera works. As I already showed you just now. And if you're gonna put it on video, you're first gonna get a black screen. Okay, don't worry about it. Touch the camera and change to picture. And then change to camera again, to video. And then you'll be good to go. Okay, so it needs a little manual how to use it, but hey, when you understand it, you can make complete reviews with this phone. No joke. Beautiful, ain't it? So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go ahead and go to the developers options. We do that by tapping the build number 7 or 8 times, and then you go to system, and then advanced, and then developers options, and then advanced reboot. And hold on, let me show you one more thing. And here you're also gonna find root, so you don't need to flash anything. You don't need Magisk or other anything. It's already rooted, okay? Don't worry about the root. So I was saying it wrong just now, that you can flash at onto ARM. It's already included. So let's reboot back into recovery. And let me flash my applications real fast on top of it. But this is the very best Android 9 that you can get for your Samsung Galaxy S2 GTI 9100. And it was created by Mr. and King Rinaldo, King of the Galaxy S2. So now I'm just gonna flash my Pux apps. And let me see, I'm gonna go for iOS Pug Mod Oreo All. Should also work for this. Sorry for the darkness there. Okay, so we're just gonna reboot. Reboot no man. And the battery went down to 16%. So yeah, when you do certain things, it might use a little bit more battery, okay? Especially things like flashing and yeah. But battery life is reasonable. Just let it charge or buy a new battery, and then you're gonna be amazed of how good the battery is. Okay, we're gonna boot into Android 9. And even though you see some Apple booting up, this thing has nothing to do with Apple. This is just one of my mods. I couldn't find the others. They are on my internal drive of my computer. So I just choose this one. And I'm kind of happy about it, because it has all the applications that I want to see in this phone. Applications that will help me to do many things. Navigation, have a compass, I can make videos, I can do many things. Here I'm gonna choose for iOS launcher, always, because that's how I would love to see my phone. So this is the latest Android with also the latest iOS look and feels. See that? I must still pimp it a little bit, put my applications on here. But it's great to know that the camera is working. That is really amazing. I think that's the most amazing thing, that the camera works. You know, because many people create all sorts of ROMs, but then we find out that this doesn't work and that doesn't work. And, you know, but of course, it's a start. You know, but then some of them, they never continue their work. So then you have, you're waiting like months for something new to come, and then nothing comes, you know. So that's why I at least make videos of the things that these guys create for the phones that I have, you know, so they know whenever they, you know, make a new ROM, they will also be credited with a nice video, you know. That gives inspiration. If you know that a certain YouTuber is always making videos of your ROMs, then, you know, you're gonna feel motivated to continue the work. Because at least one person is showing it to many others. And at least one person is loving, you know. That's how these guys think. So that's why you must always give these guys some credits. Show them some love, you know, go to their website and make them feel good. Otherwise, why would they even develop anything for us, right? If we're gonna be ungrateful or think that they are our slaves, you know? They are not our slaves. They do everything in their own time. And if you have patience, then you're gonna end up one day with something beautiful that would never exist without these guys being there for us. So remember that. So I say, amazing work again, Mr. Rinando. Thank you for your time and effort. I must say that this was a little bit confusing review. I was busy with showing this, and then at the same time I went playing with my Ubuntu phone that just came in, my BQ. I'm very happy with it, you know. You know, the guy that bidded on this phone, he put a bid from 20 euros on this phone. 20 euros for a Ubuntu phone. And then I saw that, so I contacted her. I say, hey, I want the phone. I see you have bid of 20 euros, but I don't want to put a bid like that for the phone. She said, yes, I have a bid of 20 euros. If you give me 25, then I will send it to you. I said, okay, let's do it, you know. And that's how I got my first brand new Ubuntu phone that probably nobody understood. And they wanted to get rid of it the same day that they got it. But, you know, I couldn't be happier today having this phone. So I'm gonna put in a SIM card, and probably I'm gonna make a little review of this device and find out how it works. So thanks again for watching. Thanks again, Rinando. Thanks again, Twerp family out there, and all you know, followers with the Galaxy S2 still in your possession. Thank you for watching. If you need any help or any information, just go to the link that you will find in my description. Just go to the guy's XDA. He's explaining it completely. Create a little account, you know. Tell them that you saw the video at channel 48 and you would love to install it on your how to start and what you should do. And then, you know, you're gonna find all the information out there, because these guys are very, very helpful and very friendly at the XDA community. So that was it. Thanks again for watching. If you think this information was cool, of course, leave this video a like. Liking my videos also supports my channel, you know, and brings my channel in a better, hoe je zegt dat, vaar water. So, you know, more people get to see my videos. But then again, I'm very cool with only you guys watching my video, you know, I'm just fine with that. So, see you in the next one. And of course, the next video will be, of course, showing the best ROM in 2019 for the Samsung Galaxy SI9000. So, see you in that video. Like, subscribe, and comment. Bye-bye.